Good afternoon, and welcome to the Accelerating Medicine's Partnership in Parkinson's Disease webinar. The AMPD partners are excited to bring you this resource and pleased that you could join us today for this introduction and tutorial. My name is Debra Babcock, and I'm the co-chair of the AMPD Steering Committee and multiple other AMPD working groups. I'm also the program director for Systems and Cognitive Neuroscience at NINDS, and I represent the NINDS on a number of other initiatives. I'd like to kick off this webinar by going over the agenda, which includes an overview of AMP and AMPD, as well as the AMPD portal and resources that are available in part one. Part two will provide an introduction to the Google Cloud platform, the BigQuery tool, and the AMPD Data Explorer in Terra. Part three introduces the Terra platform and provides a brief tutorial on using it, as well as information on workspaces, billing, and cost management. And finally, part four will provide an overview of the NIH Strides Cloud Discount Program, which we hope our users will be able to take advantage of. Okay, and before we get started, I want to acknowledge some of the people who've made AMPD possible. This incredible resource is brought to you by the individual cohorts, which are listed here, the BioFind study, which is a cooperative effort between the Michael J. Fox Foundation and the National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Stroke, the Harvard Biomarker Study of Brigham and Women's MGH, the NINDS Parkinson's Disease Biomarker Program, and Michael J. Fox Foundation's Parkinson Progression Markers Initiative. And of course, I want to thank all the study participants who very graciously contributed their time and information to make this possible. Finally, I want to thank all of our partners and the AMPD committee and working group members who worked so hard to make this valuable resource available to you and the community. Okay, so let's get started. I'm going to kick this off by sharing some background information on AMPD. I'll then introduce John Meckley, who will provide an introduction to the AMPD portal and the portal resources. At the end of John's presentation, we'll have time for questions. So AMPD is one of several Accelerating Medicine's partnerships. NIH partnered with FDA, life sciences firms, and multiple nonprofits with the goal of increasing the number of new diagnostics and therapies and reducing time and cost of developing them by deconstructing disease pathways. NIH has committed to investing over $300 million over 5 years on four projects. There's an AMP for Alzheimer's disease, an AMP for autoimmune disorders like rheumatoid arthritis and systemic lupus erythematosus, an AMP on Parkinson's disease, which is the one we'll be talking about today, and an AMP for type 2 diabetes. This is a picture of an article that came out last March, which goes into more detail on the AMPs for those of you who are interested. AMP-PD, AMP Parkinson's disease, is a public-private partnership between the National Institutes of Health, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, industry, which includes Celgene, GlaxoSmithKline, Pfizer, Sanofi, and Verily, and nonprofits, Michael J. Fox Foundation. This partnership is managed through the foundation of the National Institutes of Health. The goal of this partnership is to transform and accelerate drug development in Parkinson's disease by providing the expertise and support needed to determine which biomarkers show the greatest potential for predicting PD and its progression. The opening of the AMPD Knowledge Portal completes a key milestone of the AMPD project. The portal provides access to information collected from PD patients and healthy controls, and the platform will allow researchers to collectively study complex data sets and perform genome-wide analyses at a scale that was previously impossible. This slide summarizes the AMPD timeline And what I'd like to draw your attention to here is what we have planned for the future. This includes adding unbiased and targeted proteomics data to AMPD, as well as clinical and genomic information from several more study cohorts. So just so you know, there's more goodies to come. Right now, this slide summarizes what is in the AMPD knowledge platform. I won't go through all the numbers, but I'll point out that the clinical records and the RNA samples are longitudinal, which is one unique aspect in itself. Again, all this data is coming from four large cohort studies, which you see listed there. This slide shows the structure of the AMPD platform, which includes the portal, the Terra workspaces, and the data existing in the Google Cloud. Each part of the structure will be explained in detail as we go on through this webinar. At this point, I'd like to turn the discussion over to John Meckley for the overview of the portal. John is a CIT program lead for the PDBP, for the NIA and NINDS GUID servers, and John is the co-chair for the AMPD portal working group. John is responsible for the development of AMPD.org, the public-facing website for the AMPD program. So, John?
Great. Thank you, Deb. I think it's exciting that we officially launched the portal on November 15th. And focusing on the portal, its primary function is to be the publicly available, forward-facing resource that educates users about the program and facilitates account requests to the knowledge platform for access to AMPD data. A bit about the content strategy. At a high level, the website and structure was set up to maintain the consistent theme of harmonization across the program and to ensure navigation of the site is intuitive and content discovery can be quickly performed. With that, we organized the website into three primary categories. At the program level, this includes all information related to AMPD, where you can find relevant updates about the program, data releases, governance and policy information, and general how-to resources related to platform and the cloud architecture. At the data level, we provide specific information about the types of data available for analysis, including clinical data, whole genome sequencing data, and transcriptomics data. As an additional layer, we organize the related content using a consistent template that focused on providing a snapshot of the data along with key metrics, details about how the data was curated and processed, including tools and methods used by the various working groups, along with infographics to illustrate various processes. And lastly, we elaborated on what quality control measures and activities were used to ensure data accuracy and integrity. And finally, the cohort level, where we provide an overview of each cohort or study that contributed data to AMPD, along with key details about each cohort that was selected, how they were selected, specific study level inclusion exclusion criteria, and other protocol information. For this webinar, we wanted to highlight three of the main interactive features of the website and perform a live walkthrough to showcase the functionality. The first is the summary data dashboard, which displays pre-built queries using specific data points for key insights about the full data set. Second is the data dictionary that defines the clinical assessments and associated variables that were used as a basis for harmonizing the data across all four cohorts. And lastly, a quick overview regarding the online registration form that's used to allow users to request access to the knowledge platform and officially gain access to AMPD data. For the summary data dashboard, this graphically displays key clinical and sample information that highlights the harmonized data set. Visitors can filter the data dashboard to only render data from a single or select few of the cohorts. In doing so, data will be refined to only show data associated with those cohorts. Additionally, the full or filtered dashboard can be exported as an image file for external usage and reference. The expectation is that data represented here, along with the types of graphs, will expand as subsequent releases and data is added to the program. For the data dictionary, this interactive table displays the clinical assessments and specific variables that were harmonized across the full AMPD data set and is organized to show matching assessments and variables across one or more cohorts. Users can drill down further into the information to discover specifics about assessment and variable information, such as definitions, tables in BigQuery that reference each variable, the associated variable values, and any curation notes documented for reference purposes. And finally, for the application, the focus here is going to be on the process of submitting an application. The ACT will review and approve, and subsequently a member of the admin will make updates in Terra to provide access. A couple of key points to notate here are the requirements necessary to complete an application. A user must read and electronically agree to the AMPD data use agreement along with publication policy, provide a valid Google account via a Gmail or linked institutional or organizational account with two-step verification enabled. In the application, there are links and references directly in the form that users can reference in order to set this up. Users must complete the researcher and profile information sections, and then lastly, select a access type that they wish to gain access to. Key point here is that the form is set up to be a single submission. If any changes are necessary for your access type or any changes are needed to be made to your application, please reach out to the ACT directly to facilitate that process. AMPD data is organized using a two-tier model. Specifics about what exact data is included in each of these tiers will be provided later in this webinar. Tier 1 provides access to participant-level clinical data, and Tier 2 provides full access to all AMPD data, including participant-level clinical, genomic, and transcriptomic data. A key takeaway here is that anyone requesting Tier 2 data must complete, sign, and provide an institutional signature on the data use agreement. Users can download and upload this document directly in the application upon submitting their application. At the time of submitting your application, if you are unable to obtain an institutional signature, you can still submit the form. A member of the ACT will reach out with you offline and coordinate obtaining that information directly prior to providing access to Tier 2 data. This concludes the portion of the AMPD portal webinar. Are there any questions?
I see there is one question so far from a user asking, will you be able to filter based on location, i.e. state?
For the summary data dashboard, that functionality is not currently available.
The multiple data sets have been harmonized across all the different cohorts, and the information has been thoroughly de-identified. So that kind of deep level information is not available on AMPD. However, if you are interested in additional information that's not on the AMPD website, we encourage you to go back to the original cohorts, all of which are making data publicly available to you.